Welcome to Women Awakening. I'm Cynthia James, and this network is about changing lives one woman at a time.
We're changing the planet one woman at a time. We're changing lives one woman at a time. We are creating experiences that make a difference on this planet. I'm your host, Cynthia James, and I'm very happy to be with you. I get the honor of bringing extraordinary women to you. Some I've known for a long time, some I've just met, you know, but all have been on a journey of awakening, and they are all here because they want to inspire other women to do great things. So my guest today is Stacy Sherman, and I'll tell you how we met in a little bit, but let me tell you a little bit about her. Over the past 20 years, she's worked in all size companies and advertising agencies, leading sales and digital marketing. She has recently, in 2018, moved to a company called Schindler Elevator and head of Customer Experience North America Division. She's been building and leading an extraordinary group of people that are dedicated to delivering customer service. This is one of the things I loved about her website. It said, "It's in our control to humanize business." And she's passionate about it. So welcome, Stacy Sherman.
Thank you so much.
So I want to tell you how I met her. I know her dad, and we were in Palm Desert, and we were having lunch with her sister, and I had not met her, and we ended up sitting next to each other, and she had all of these tips on efficiency, and I was like, I need to know this woman, and I know what she's doing. And during that conversation, we talked a little bit about her passion for women. So I'm grateful that you're here, and tell us about this passion that you have.
Yes. Well, I think even our meeting is just proof in the pudding that the universe has our back and brings us connections even when we're not looking for it. And I mean, that's, you know, you and I coming together, it just truly was, it is what we're talking about, that authenticity, and everything happens for a reason.
Absolutely.
Yes. So my passion around humanizing business and women leadership as well comes from me working in a corporate environment for over 28 years and have not always had a seat at the table when I thought I needed to. The whole concept of inclusion and just feeling like belonging is something that doesn't happen unless it's very intentional. And there was a circumstance that happened to me that pivoted me to say, okay, I'm never going to change big companies, but I can change how I lead and how I show up. And that's really what started me with the focus of humanizing business. And that means really engaging employees, employee appreciation, and in the end, customer satisfaction, so that there's a greater happiness everywhere.
That's beautiful. You know, so I love that you've done this in corporations. I love that you've been a blogger. And I love that you've created a whole community on LinkedIn. You know, tell us a little bit about your blogging and why that's been important to you.
So my blogging has been simply a platform to allow me to express my views and thoughts about all these topics. And when I started it over 2 years ago, I really didn't know where it would go. And I took a chance. I was a little nervous to express myself and put myself out there. Would anyone even read it? And over time, doing things wrong quickly in the beginning and learning from it, I am where I am today in being interviewed and featured by authors and keynote speakers and even people like you who want to share my voice the platform has been powerful because it, and I wouldn't have had these opportunities if it wasn't for that.
Yeah. And so if I want to be a blogger, yeah. What advice would you give me?
I say, just do it, like Nike says. Mm-hmm. I would say that it took me about 3 years before I actually did it because I was afraid of the technology. I was afraid of what I didn't know. I was afraid of doing it wrong. And I wish I could go back in time because my blog would have been about 5-6 years old instead of 2.5 years old. And that's my advice is just, there's so many YouTube videos. There's so many people out there who actually are hungry for business right now to help people get started online. And even me, I can offer advice to people on my journey. But once you make up your mind and you're intentional that this is something you want to do, it's not hard. It's just our own fear sometimes gets in the way.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, I coach a lot of women and they really, this technology thing is fascinating, you know, for a lot of them, you know, they have made up stories about what will or will not work for them. And once they get into it, it's like, oh, well, it wasn't as hard as I thought it was going to be, you know?
Yes. Yes. Anticipation's always harder than the real thing when it happens.
Exactly. So what's been the biggest challenge, you know, for you to humanize business? You know, I mean, one of the things you said is like having a seat at the table, but what do you think's the biggest challenge you've had in terms of bringing this idea to fruition?
I would say not at my current company, but other places I've worked, them really understanding the why. It's so much about profit. And where I am passionate about is, and what I continue to demonstrate is that, think about Starbucks as an example. I don't go there because I like paying triple the price for a cup of coffee or tea. I go there because of the experience. And there's really best practices for companies to apply to be able to create those experiences for people. And they don't buy just on price. So I had to, my challenge was getting people to care, to listen, to understand that customer experience is so important. And here's why. And then adopt it and get people at the top. Culture starts at the top, getting those people at the top to really champion it. So yeah. That was initial challenges.
Yeah. Well, that's beautiful. What, I think any person or any company that's not clear about their why can't provide the kind of service that you're talking about because it's scattered and because they're in the fear mode of trying to make the money and trying to, you know, compete with other people as opposed to creating a container that people can come into and feel nurtured and supported.
Yeah. Yes. Yes. In fact, Gartner, a big research firm, has my favorite quote I continue to use is that customer experience is overtaking product and price as a brand differentiator. So to me, that's why I stick with this field and I'll probably never leave it because I really believe in that.
Yeah. So you've got this community on LinkedIn. You know, what are you seeing as one of the biggest challenges for women who are in leadership?
Yeah. So just like the blog, the Women Leaders Making a Difference on LinkedIn is something I just started out of the blue. Started with two people. Now we're almost 450 CEOs, entrepreneurs, and more. And it's a safe place for people to ask questions and feel like there's no judgment to get some advice, and they're all authentic connections. So that's what I'm really proud about. To your question, or restate the question, so I make sure.
Yeah, what do you think women leadership leaders are struggling with? What do you think is one of the biggest things?
I think that it's about. I think they're showing up more, but it's how they show up. In other words, people are still afraid to advocate what they believe, or it's just speaking up. They're showing up, but not always speaking up. And right. I think it's just fear and confidence. And that's what I want to help change.
Right. That's beautiful. Okay. So I'm assuming you have a personal life. You're not just working 24/7. So tell us about your personal life and how you are creating harmony between this passion you've got in business and your personal life.
Yeah, that's a great question. Although I feel like I'm working all the time, but it doesn't feel like work. So that's the beauty of it. Mm. But personally, so I have two kids in college, and I just got used to being an empty nest. And then this pandemic hit, and now they're home until who knows. So goodbye, empty nest. Hello, family. And it's all good. It's just a matter of pivoting. How do we all adapt to being together all the time now? No one leaving, online classes, my work continues. And sometimes I have to admit, in the very beginning of stay at home, I was connecting more with people through my computer than I was at home, because everybody was still so confused at what is going on here. But now we've gotten into our new normal, and now we're having dinners together and planning some time together, because if you don't plan it, just because you're in the same house doesn't mean it happens.
Exactly.
So my family is my balance between when I'm not working.
Yeah. Oh, that's beautiful. Well, I think it's really important for women to know that, you know, you can create this field of expressing your passion and at the same time enjoy the luxury of partnership or family or however that looks for you. I just think sometimes we think it has to be either or, and I think it's in being intentional about what you want to create that's important.
I believe it's intentional, and I also really believe it takes a village. I couldn't do half the things I do and be able to work as much as I do without a strong partner in crime, my husband and friends. And at work, I have an amazing team and cross teams I work with that it takes a village. We never could do any of all this ourselves.
Yeah. Well, I love your heart, and I love your passion, and I want to let people know how they can get in touch with you. How do they find you?
Oh, thank you for that. So I would say through my blog, doingcxright.com. You could also email me at Stacy without an E, Stacy, at doingcxright.com. And I love collaborating. I love storytelling. So yes, please let's keep the conversations going.
That's great. And if they wanted to, if they're leaders and they wanted to be in your LinkedIn group, how do they do that?
Yes, the best thing to do is connect with me on LinkedIn. You can find me. It says Stacy Sherman, and then it says Doing CX Right as well. Because there's a lot of Stacy Shermans apparently in the world. So that's the easiest way. I'll just invite you in.
Beautiful. So before you go, what do you want women to know about awakening? What do you want them to know about stepping into their full expression?
I would say build your confidence. And then when you do, it's going to allow you to be the boss, know the boss, and show up really authentically.
That's beautiful. Well, and you do exactly that. And so I'm really grateful that you were here. I'm grateful that the women get to know you and that we get to experience you and your passion in the world.
Thank you so much.
So ladies, I hope you've enjoyed this. I hope you'll come back time and time again, because we're consistently putting up a new product and introducing you to new women. I want you to know that you are a powerful manifester, that you are here because you are a grand design that is essential to be on this planet in this moment. You are a woman awakening, and I'm extraordinarily grateful to be in your presence. We'll see you on the next one.